commentator coming on to the comms, wanting to just do something useful while waiting for the next bracket match. Looks like we have Keith versus Noodle. Noodle historically a fit main, but since he's made his goal of getting on the Chicago PR, number 15, I believe, he's decided to switch it up. And everyone told him to pick up Rob, so here we are. Reminiscent of Summit, where both... rough to see. But yeah, this is reminiscent of Summit, where both Jazzo, who's a Ken main, and Anathema both premiered. Now, I can't honestly remember if Jazzo and Anathema actually played like, in the main bracket. But I can imagine it being rough for Ken. However, you know, Keith, with a unfortunate SD from Noodle, Keith has been maintaining the advantage. And sure you can. Yeah, the so Rob has, you know, some decent poking tools, but you know, his best approach tool is kind of going in, you know, for the red nair. Problem is, the Shotos, I believe, have a better parry. No. That's what I've heard, at least. If not, I mean, they just are used to parrying to get to open up their opponents. And Keith is showing that in full force here, again and again, just parrying the nair. So forcing Noodle to approach, especially with nair, is, you know, really working out for Keith here, maintaining the lead. But honestly, not really trying too hard to actually, like, hamper zone or be play defensive. Keith is instead, you know, going in and just banking on the fact that Noodle is also trying to go in. And in close combat, you know, probably Ken is looking at it. And even without rage, that is just too high of a percent. The smell of burnt electronics in the air as, you know, Keith grabs Rob by his robot arms and just sizzles the silicon. I guess Rob is like some sort of alien robot, question mark, so they might not be made out of silicon. You know, there are talks about how, you know, you can make different electronics out of different materials. Anyways, back to the game. Town. I think it's a pretty good counterpick stage for Noodle. Has a fairly small floor of blast zones, which is good for, you know, or bad for characters with not super great vertical recoveries. Rob does have a great vertical recovery. And it makes sense. The ceiling, I believe, is fairly high on this stage, so, you know, also good to not get killed as early. Ooh, the focus. And still, Noodle calling out a roll, or just, you know, an option other than shield with a side B. Not a bad approach. And it's a multi-hit, so if he tries to parry, very good timing on the down air. Rob's down air seems almost as good as Ivysaur's down air. Maybe even like the same range, but ooh, a high ceiling not going to save Noodle there. But the Rob's down air, you know, I think has a bit longer startup, which is why it might not be quite as good. Alright, both of them exchanging blows. Thankfully, you know, Rob having a good enough vertical recovery to recover from that air dodge off stage. I'm seeing surprisingly little down tilt coming from Newton here. It's a hitbox that won't necessarily get hit by up tilts. And it's a decent, like, mid-range poke tool, right? Like, daring Keith to approach after, you know, maybe after the gyro's already out. Noodle trying to set up for perhaps a one of those zero to deaths Rob is known for, especially after Summit. Anathema really repping the explosiveness of this character. Keith recognizing his either fair hair, can't quite remember, but his attack having a better hitbox that can go around Rob's side B hitbox. Seems like. So this is the last stock, but oh my goodness, not connecting. This is Noodle's winner's bracket stock. And I would be. That was almost it. Yep. The parry just obliterating Rob there. Rob's down air, or Rob's neutral air is already minus four.